Hour of Hope. Message of Salvation. Time of Refreshing. And a Moment of Grace.
Grace Ministries.
Turning trashes into treasure.
Hours of Hope.
Today on the Hour of Hope.
I tell you, after sacrifice, here comes the abundance of rain. After the sacrifice, he said, I hear the sound of abundance of rain. I'm hearing the sound of abundance of rain as well in the spirit over this nation, over this continent.
Welcome to the Hour of Hope with Pastor Chioma Emmanuel with today's message.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Welcome for this wonderful Hour of Hope. Thank God for what the Lord is doing with Hour of Hope. I bless God for this Hour of Hope. And indeed, this Hour of Hope is a time God, you know, used to visit His children. There will be a great difference. Maybe you'll be praying, asking God for directions about this year, what is going to happen this year. And I believe that even as I'm in your sitting room right now, or maybe in your office right now, maybe anywhere you're watching me, maybe in prison, in any part of the world, or in the hospital, wherever you are, I just want you to know in Jesus' name that thing you've been asking, getting worried for, that God has given me a message to come and give to you. And the message God gave to me is a message that I picked from the book of, from the 2 Kings chapter 8, that spoke about a woman, you know, whose son died. And this woman was worried and troubled. But when she went to the man of God, Elijah said to her, woman, arise and go back to your people. She walked with instructions that God gave to her. Say, arise and go back to your people as sojourn there, you know, and everything that I've stolen from you, God said that He will give it back to you. So, child of God, maybe you're watching me today. The good news I came with you to is that there shall be a release. Child of God, God will release your marriage. We release your husband to your destiny this year. We release your wife to you this year. But you got to position yourself. Not see yourself that, oh, I've been praying all this year. Let me give up. Let me tell you, anything you give up will never happen. But the things that you challenge and work for will always happen. There is a year of release, because it's at the end, as I read, you know, earlier yesterday, at the end of each seventh, at the end of every seventh year, in the book of Deuteronomy 15, he said, at the end of every seventh year, thou shalt make a release. Thou shalt make a release. And hear what the word of God says in verse 2. He said, and this is the manner of the release. Every creditor thou lendeth out unto his neighbor shall release it. He shall not excite it of his own neighbor or of his own brother, because it is called the Lord's release. Because it is called the Lord's release. Whether your brother owe you, whether your sister owe you, he's been owing you for 7 years, he didn't pay you, did you die? You didn't die. God said release. He's wronged you for 7 years, you're still angry. God said release. He's been standing on your team for a long time, he didn't want to give you back. God said release. You know why you should release? You should release so that there will be a release. You should ask God to put in your position, to put you in a position whereby, because you know why? Once you release to a man, God release back to you. But that's what people don't know. You release your creditors, you release your offenders, you release people that have wronged you, God will release back to you. You release blessings into people's lives. That's why last week when I was having my life program, and the Lord said to me, speak to every woman who is believing God for fruit of the womb to release a memorial offering on the pulpit you know, in remembrance of covenant with God. If you want God to release, to bring blessing into your life, you got to do what God wants you to do. The children of Israel, when they now went back to man of God, I believe that these nations of the world, I mean, not just United Kingdom, not just Europe, you know, every part of the world, I believe if we can return back to God and cry to God and say, Lord, have mercy on us, I'm telling you, and let a sacrifice of our souls before the Lord, let the leaders of the nations of the world go before God and cry to God and say, Lord, many of you may be listening to me and say, what is she talking about? But I'm telling you what I'm talking about as a servant of God. God said there will be a release this year. If any nation that the leaders could go to God and lay their life before God and submit their soul and cry out to nation, do you know how it will look? If today, let's say, Gordon Brown could call, the Prime Minister of UK could call for night vigil for the whole nation, for us to seek God, that God will visit the nation. We are not happy to see our children on the streets. We are not happy to see how things are going. Homes are breaking, marriages, devil is attacking homes. Many are committing suicide. Men are drunkards on the street. If any time I go on the street to minister, I see many men. A man told me why he's a drunkard. A man who is a computer and analyst eventually turned to a drunkard because his wife left him and ran away with another woman. And people are thinking that things are not happening. Children have no respect for their parents, and we are sitting down only working on policies and procedures and not telling children, if your parents offend you, you should call police. If your parents want to correct you, you should call police. If they rebuke you, call police. I tell you, and that's why we have so many children ended up, there is no solution to it. They ended up in care. From care, before you know it, they sanctioned them in the hospital, or they became armed robbers and thieves walking around the street. And we are saying that all is well. Let me tell you, man shall not live by bread alone. It's not because of food, it's not because of what we're eating, but it's because of the presence of God. Something needs to be done in the land. If the Prime Minister today and the Queen today can say, let nation have a vigil, let everybody come out and let us cry to God, even for 2 hours, I tell you, God will hear, and there will be a release of God's presence. That was what that nation did. They went back to the man of God, and the man of God heard, and he said to them, go and prepare me 7 altars. And they prepared 7 altars of sacrifice. There was a great sacrifice. I'm still preaching on release. I've not even got to restoration, but I know that there will be a release in the name of Jesus over this nation. And I pray, mighty God, that you will begin to touch the people from the head down to toe, oh Lord, even unborn babies in this nation. Father, Lord, touch people, oh Lord, that we will come together, that ministers will work together, not being seen ourselves as we are, this person is this, and some religion are working together and possessing the land. And out of the whole thing that is in the land, we don't even have up to 1 million Christian, 1 million born again, we don't have. And everybody is fighting each other. Why, we have a great job to be done. Lord, let there be a release, Lord, of your insight of what you've called us to do in this land. All the ministers, both born here and the ones you brought in to come and direct your children back to yourself. Father, let there be a release of that. And I began to say to you, children of God, when the children of God did it in that land, the man of God, there was a sacrifice led. He said, prepare me 7 altars. And the altars were prepared. And there was a sacrifice. I tell you, after sacrifice, here comes the abundance of rain. After the sacrifice, he said, I hear the sound of abundance of rain. I'm hearing the sound of abundance of rain as well in the spirit over this nation, over this continent, over London. I'm hearing the sound of abundance of rain. Children of God, I decree there shall be a sound of abundance of rain over this continent. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we decree this continent for Jesus, because Jesus must reign. He is the only way. He is the Lord. When we position ourselves, he will release. there will be a release. And I know no man can stop it. Any man that wants to stand against it, God knows how to take people out and do whatever he wants to do.
Join us every Sunday at Grace Ministries at the Holiday Inn, 1 Silvertown Way, Canningtown E16, 2 minutes walk from Canningtown Station, for an encounter with a God who will turn your trashes into treasures. And your life will not be the same again. Coming soon. Special New Year DVD Bonanza from Grace Ministries. This special DVD packs contain Pastor Chioma's best-selling messages on the family, overcoming barrenness, dealing with anger, what do you see, prophesy, come nearer, stir up the troubled waters, the five porches, his name is wonderful, and the future begins. In these soul-searching and life-transforming messages, God uses his woman servant to prophesy and direct the body of Christ on sound biblical teachings that will usher his people into what he has in store for them in 2008 and beyond. Visit our website and watch Pastor Chioma and other powerful programs from Grace Ministries live on www.thegraceministries.org.uk. Join us on the last Saturday of each month for Faith Clinic, a place of divine expectation, where you can expect inspirational praise, anointed worship, God's forgiveness, God's touch, an answer to your prayer, and a prophetic word to change your life. For your expectation of a good future will not be cut off.
Position yourself, prepare yourself that you may hear the sound of abundant offering, because there will be abundant offering, there will be a release of that which has been holding up for 7 years. After 7 years, there must be a release. Maybe you've been married for 7 years. I tell you, this is your year. You haven't had child or you haven't had peace. There must be a restoration in that marriage, because maybe you've been married for 27 years, anything that have to do with 7, maybe 14 years. I tell you, there will be a restoration. Maybe 7 months, maybe 7 weeks, there will be a restoration, because after it, here comes blessing. I said to somebody, when my spiritual father called me on a night of 7 days, 7th hour, seventh, he said, get the church in prayer and speak to the church. He said, there is a shifting in the spirit. I said, daddy, that is a confirmation from God. So why am I saying this, children of God? There is a confirmation since on the 7th hour, 7th minute, 7th second, 7th month, 7th year, 2007, there was a shifting. A shifting for a release for you. Maybe you say, Pastor, I've done everything I could, but nothing is happening. I'm telling you, something is about to happen. As long as you walk in all this, righteousness, holiness, position yourself, plant yourself in the house of the Lord. A place where you are, you're not bearing fruit, child of God, get yourself out of that place. Or maybe you're not bearing fruit because your mindset, you even want to drive your pastor to the pulpit to take up. Not everybody have to preach. Some of you, even like my producer who is producing me now, it's a ministry. So it's a ministry. Anything we are doing is ministry. If you don't know how to do it, that's why if he's not in ministry, he will feel me like as if I'm going to party. Like somebody has come wants to feel me as if I'm having a party. I say, what is this? You know? But if you are in ministry, if it's your ministry, the word flows with you. He feels sin, whatever that is coming out of me, he picks it up, and when he wants to work with it, he see it, he work. There are different kinds of ministry. Position yourself that God will be able to do whatever he wants to do with you. My husband and I, we were talking, and I said to my husband, all these things that people are running up and down, people are trying to make money, people are trying. Listen, making money is not try. God likes hardworking people. But God do not want you to live for working. God wants you to live for him. Then he will not give you the power of mind to be able to work and acquire. But when I said to my husband, I said, all these struggles, if people tomorrow should drop dead, or let's say some say, okay, my children will take over. But assuming now Christ come today, do you know what the word of God says? He said a stone will not be left on top of each other. Because if you know that there is a place where you're going, that's why I thank God. I know, you know, bank here can fail me. You know, I may not have money here, but you see in heaven, I am very wealthy. I'm telling you, I am. Because I know that is where my money is. That is where my money, I can't spend all my life investing in the kingdom, and you who don't invest expect to reign the same way with me. It's not gonna happen. It's not. So now the quicker you begin to learn how to invest, he said, do not spend your time, your effort for that which maggots will be eating up. But to that which is saved in heaven. So begin to prepare yourself, child of God. Begin to ask God, because God will give you all this, but still, don't let all this be the big deal. I remember there a brother, oh, pastor, I need job. I said, immediately as I was praying for him, the Lord said to me, he's gonna give him a great contract in Africa. And since he got that contract, nobody hear from him again. He make money. I remember again somebody say, oh, if I pay my tithe in their church, they'll be so rich, so let me leave. You've not even got the money, you're saying that about tithe. Then today, where is the money? So people cannot. God knows how to handle things, children of God. I'm saying to you, get yourself prepared. Position yourself so that when the rain comes, the rain of blessings, because there will be a release of it. When that rain comes, you will be able to stay in a position where you are dry garden, your desolate place will receive the water. That is what I'm talking about. Prepare yourself, child of God, because there shall be a release. After the seventh year, he said, it's the release of the Lord. Hallelujah. Okay, let's go to verse 3. He said, of a foreign, I'm still reading from Deuteronomy chapter 15. Mind you, I said to you, this is not preaching, this is message. How you will position yourself and how you will be where God wants you to be if you need the release. That's why I've been teaching, I've been delivering the message that the Lord gave to me, to you, you know. Then he said of Deuteronomy 15 verse 3, he said, of a foreigner, thou mayest excite it again. But that which is thine with thy brother, thy hand shall release. That which is thine with thy brother and thy hand shall release. God is saying to you here, of a foreigner, don't excite a foreigner, rather release it. Some of us, we have visitors, though it's a pity that this day you have some visitors, instead of them to come and live and relax, but what they want to do is to even come and take you out of your house, sit down there and start stealing and start planning evil about you. But let me tell you, that wouldn't stop us, because I get the stage, I say, no, I don't want no visitor anymore in my house, you know. But God knows how to do it, you know. But thank God today, my house is the pastor's quarters, and they come and they release God's blessings, you know. But you got to be careful the kind of people you bring into your home, you know. We have to get a place just for the pastors, not just for anybody, you know. Strangers, foreigners, treat them as if they're your own people. Don't treat them bad, because you can treat somebody wrong. You never know whether it's an angel that is going your way, and then you treat that person bad, you know. So try and treat people good, because life is a seed. Whatsoever seed is, so you will reap. If you sow good in people, you will receive good, you know. Release to them. You may be tomorrow, you may not be, you may be your children that find themselves in a foreign land, like some of us, like me. I'm not born here, but I find myself in a foreign land because God said to me, take your children and go back. My kids are here, but me, I'm not, you know. But that does not stop me from being all the benefit any other person got. I've got it, you know. They have the same passport with me, I have the same thing, you know. That does not change me, that does not make me different, that makes me to be who God has made me to be. So that wouldn't make you a child of God to think, oh, God is against you. No, God is not against you, rather God is with you. God wants you to care for people, care for them, love them. It's a seed. Sow a seed that your children will reap. Sow a seed that anywhere your children go, they will receive blessing. There are some people, even there are some presidents, when you see their children, you don't want to have anything to do with them because they sow bad seed. But there are some, I sat down one day and somebody brought somebody to me, oh, do you know this person is that president's child? So I said, so? Because to me, it doesn't mean anything to me. Even one of them wanted to rent my house in Golders Green. My husband said, no, I'm not putting him into my house because of the bad way they treated the nation. So this is what God is talking about. So, but if he has sown a good seed, God will return back to him with good seed. But if you sow a bad seed, you will always reap a bad seed. So if you want a release, treat foreigners right, treat strangers well, treat people well, treat them well, because tomorrow it could be your turn. That's why I prefer to do anything for any foreigner that comes my way, you know. That's why I thank God for our church, you know. It's a worship center for all nations. It's not one-sided church. That's why I bless God, you know. Everybody is there. All nation, all men, at least a new church with up to 15 nationalities. You could see what the Lord is doing. It's not about one person. It's about God for what the Lord is doing. So get yourself prepared, position yourself, ask God, learn their language, learn how to relate with people, learn how to flow with people, learn how to make them feel important. It doesn't matter where they are coming from. We are all children of God, created by God. And God, if you see that, he will make you even more important. He will release anointing of importance in you. Hallelujah. And then we are proceeding. And God said in the book of Joel 2, he said, I will do a great thing. What is the great thing God is going to do in your life? God is going to do a great thing that this year, your body will not taste sickness in Jesus' name. He will do a great thing that you've been married for years, but this year is your year, children will begin to cry in the house. You have children, you don't know how to go about it. Whether drug has taken them away from you, or the society, or maybe even they ran into care. They are living in care. And you see yourself as a woman who has nobody anymore. Because I remember when my son was also misbehaving, I smacked him, and next day they came and they picked him. And I cried and cried and cried and cried. And I said to them, listen, you cannot take my child away from me. And eventually they took him, and afterwards they got tired. And the Lord, I went in and cried to God, and there was a release. Child of God, no matter the law, no matter the situation, no matter how they've done it, I decree over that child situation, let there be a release in Jesus' name. No matter whatever you've been going through, maybe financially it's been so tight that even at times before you get one penny, you got debt of 30 pence. But I decree over your spirit today in Jesus' name that a release of abundance will come upon your life. But let me tell you, many of you that are believing God for finance, for financial breakthrough, it's only one thing that God uses to bless people. One thing. What is the one thing? One thing, first of all, is be faithful to your tithe paying. When you are faithful to your tithe paying and you are faithful to your giving, child of God, you will never, 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 never lack. There will always be a release. Do you know in the book of Malachi chapter 3, the only place God said, try me, put me to test and see if I will not open up the windows of heaven and pour down my blessings over you. That is the only place. He said, when you pay your tithe. He said, but if you do not pay your tithe, he said, you will be cursed with a curse. Anytime you find yourself struggling, tithe people will never pay tithe. I'm telling you, if you are tithe, you can never pay tithe. And you know what devil is trying to do? Is to block you to eat your seed. When you eat your seed, how do you expect harvest? You cannot harvest nothing because you've eaten up your seed. Pay your tithe to the church where you are being faith. That's what the word of God says. Pay your tithe to a church where you are being faith. It's a pity that this day people share all kinds of flyers, say your tithe, say your tithe. I'm on television preaching to you. Unless if you are sending offering or a partner to my ministry, you cannot send your tithe to me because I am not your pastor. Many people send their tithe to me and I return it back. It's not for me. Listen, we thank God for money, but money that is taken wrongly can destroy anointing and it will not bless you as well. So pay your tithe in the house where you are being fed. And many of you pay tithes after you pay tithes, after you pay tax. That's not what the word of God says. The word of God says, he said, you take your tithe first of all and give to God. Take your tithe first of all. That's why many of you that are working, you should ask them for pay as you earn.
Coming soon. Special New Year DVD Bonanza from Grace Ministries. This special DVD packs contain Pastor Chioma's best-selling messages on the family, overcoming barrenness, dealing with anger, what do you see, prophesy, come nearer, stir up the troubled waters, the five porches, his name is wonderful, and the future begins. In these soul-searching and life-transforming messages, God uses his woman servant to prophesy and direct the body of Christ on sound biblical teachings that will usher his people into what he has in store for them in 2008 and beyond.
You are watching Hour of Hope.
Thank you for watching Hour of Hope.
Worship with us at Bethel Place, 203 Freemason Road, Custom House, Canning Town, London, E16 3PG. Hour of Hope is brought to you by Grace Ministries and supporters like you.
To partner with us, please call 0044 2070555110.
Grace Ministries,
turning trashes into treasure.